Hi guys and welcome back to the show. Today I'll be doing a turducken, which is something really good for a festive season. This is actually my simplified version, much easier than the traditional way you do it. I'll be actually doing it in the camp oven today, which is on top of a gas stove. So let's get to it. Okay, we'll just get some heat into the camp oven. Just put him on high for a bit, take a few minutes, put everything off to the side so we can get started onto the stuffing. Now this is a homemade one where I'll just use fresh bread, fresh garlic and fresh sage, a little bit of butter and a little bit of olive oil. So first thing we're going to do is just cut the bread into just a rough dice. It's better to use fresh ingredients. If you've only got dried, you know, sage or whatever, use that, but fresh is much better. And the garlic, you can cut it as thick as you like. Okay, now we've done the sage, we can move over to the camp oven, which is nice and hot. The next step is just to add some olive oil and butter to your pan, wok, whatever you're using. I'll throw everything in together, so the bread, the garlic and the sage. A little bit of salt and pepper, and just keep sort of tossing it or sauteing it through, just so you get all the flavors to sort of amalgamate, and just give it a bit of a mix around. You really just want it to sort of coat everything. Like I said before, you can brown it if you want to, you don't really need to. You just really want to get the flavors going. Just get a little bit of color into it and just coat everything really. Okay, it's all done now. So we'll just get him all out. You can see it's absorbed all the butter and the oil. That's where all the flavor is, to be honest. Okay, the stuffing is now done, so I'll move everything out of the way and we'll get on to actually making the turducken itself. Now this is going to be rolled, so what I'll do is grab some foil. Depending obviously on the size of your turducken is going to depend on how much foil you use, so that's a bit of a hard one. But with me, two big pieces are fine. Okay, so I'll just grab the, I've actually got Serrano ham this time. Prosciutto, Serrano, it doesn't really matter. I know you probably have some Spanish people that'll disagree with me and Italians, but it's all the same, I think. Now you can use bacon. And honestly, if you don't want to use either, you don't have to. I just think it gives it a nice flavour, and when it's finished, it just looks nice, looks pretty. Now just keep layering this down until you get to where you think it's going to be, like lengthways and widthways. Put this over here for now, then we'll get on to the rest of the meal. Now when you bash something out, always use some plastic in between both. I like using these bags, that just lasts longer. You can use glad wrap, doesn't really matter. Okay, so first with the chicken thigh, so just put it in between like that. Bash that out reasonably thin. That way it doesn't stick to your board. So just lay it on and just repeat the process. Okay, next thing we'll get onto is the duck. Now remove the skin. Butterfly it open a little bit. Then do the same thing I did with the chicken thigh. Okay, we'll just grab him over to the board in front of me. Just give it a little bit of a light season. And
there.
We'll just grab the turkey mince, just layer that down. Then put the bread mix on top of that. Then when that's all done, then you gently roll the whole dish together. Now, it's quite easy. Just grab the edge of the foil and just lift it. You'll see, you know, a bit of it does drop out. That doesn't honestly matter. And as you push it down, just push down on it gently, just to sort of, I suppose, form a log. And as you roll it, it'll keep doing the same thing until the whole thing is covered. As you can see from there, just get the other piece of foil and just roll it up. Now, once it's rolled up, just grab the ends, just give it a little bit of a twist, just to secure it. Then we're ready to put it into the oven. Now that it's all rolled up, ready to go, we'll just turn the stove back on. We'll put it on high for now, and we'll just add a little bit of oil. Just that just gives it a bit more heat once it's going and gives a bit of a smoky flavour. Now let's grab one of these trivets and put that in. And we'll grab the turducken and try and jam him in, which just fits. It will shrink a tiny bit once it's going. Then we'll just put the lid on. And I'd say every, say, 15 minutes, I'll give it a bit of a turn and probably adjust the heat depending on how it's going. Okay, while that's going, I'll just give it a bit of a clean up. Okay, it's been on for about 15 minutes, so I'll just give it a check. We'll just get the lid off. Just give them a bit of a turn. Just about quarter way. And we'll just give them another about 15 again. Okay, it's well and truly on the go now. What I'm going to do is just add a little bit of chicken stock to it, which will just help, I suppose, steam it as well as bake it. And it's not going to burn any of the juices that are in there because I want to make a gravy out of the bottom. You've just got to be more careful that you're not going to burn the bottom. That's why it is on a trivet. So just watch it and just turn it regularly. Okay, now it's been about an hour. Now all we'll do here is just move the foil over a little bit. Get a sharp knife, just go down about halfway, and when you press it, yep, you see the liquid's coming out clear. That means it actually is cooked. Okay, now we'll just get him out. It's gonna be a bit hot. Now they can just rest there until we've made the sauce. From here, we're just gonna go on and make a bit of a simple sort of gravy. Okay, so it's on a low heat. We'll just pull the trivet out and I'll just add, just a little bit of butter. Because what we're going to do is make a gravy the proper way, which is using flour. So we're making what's called a roux, which really just absorbs all the really nice flavors that are actually in there already. Okay, so we'll just put a little bit of flour in. And the flour is just to absorb all the oils that are in there. Kind of the consistency you want. You don't want it too thick. It can't be too thin. If it's too thin, like runny, when you make your gravy, it'll become oily. When it's like that, it won't. Just turn it around a little bit, just to get a little bit of color. Well, it's already got a lot of color to it, obviously, but just so it binds up together. Once it's all like that, then we can add the stock. Now with the stock, just add a little bit at a time. If you add too much, it'll be too hard to get it nice and consistent. Just keep adding liquid till it absorbs it enough. You'll need to bring it to the boil. If you don't bring it to the boil, you'll get that real floury sort of taste, which you don't want. This way you're not using any gravy powder, anything like that. You're just using all the natural flavors that came out of the chicken. Now, obviously you can do this with any meat. Now just turn it down just a little bit, just so it's a simmer. And right at the end, we'll just add a bit of cream to it. I always like cream. It's good. It's good for it. Okay, the gravy's all done now. So we'll just move over to the turducken now. I'll unwrap it and then we'll get ready to serve it. Gently take the foil off. It'll come off pretty easy anyway. Just roll him over. Okay, just give it a slice. Yeah, you can see all the beautiful different colours and everything inside it. Got the stuffing down the bottom. Looks pretty good, actually. Probably good enough to eat, even. Okay, we'll just get some gravy onto it. And we'll just put a little bit of chives on there. And there you have it. There you go, guys. There's my take on a turducken. It's definitely something you can do when you go camping, but also you can do it at home. And it's much easier than the traditional method of doing it. I hope you enjoyed the show. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. And please comment below with anything you'd like to know about the dish today. Give it a try, eh? Yum. Thanks for watching. See you next time, guys.